So, structural linguistics has four characteristics. Number one is, to find out the reality, one has to go into the unconscious infrastructure of the phenomena. But a conscious phenomena may not give you the right sense of reality. To find out the reality, one has to go into the unconscious infrastructure of reality. For example, observable behavior may be a misnomer, that what you have observed may not give you the real meaning. The nature of relationships, we always say, I am impressed. Well, that first instance will not show the reality. What is this back biting? What is this stabbing from the back? What is this sweet poison? You understand this? Because that is an impressionable expression one has calculated. Impressionable expression one has calculated. It's not like this. One has to, conscious phenomena may not give you the reality. You have to enter into the unconscious infrastructure, structural linguistics. Great. Observable behavior is a misnomer. All right. Number two, structural linguistics does not take terms as independent entities. Rather, takes the interrelationship coherence between them to understand the meaning. For example, I am showing you this one. T as T has no meaning. T is a letter. T as T has no meaning. C as C has no meaning. A as A has no meaning. Make a coherence. C A T, cat, means name of an animal. All right. Social phenomena, relationships are also like this. I have heard that you are speaking against me, but you have not heard the whole thing. What are the situation? What are the intention? You have just seen little bit. Always doubting has no meaning. Yes, one can be skeptical, but one has to realize the holism. Don't understand things by part. Understand things through holism. What is the whole thing? T as T has no meaning. Okay. One part has no meaning. Alright. Third is, structural linguistics introduces the concept of a system. System, you remember? Many interconnected, interdependent parts. Total whole system. Fourth is, structural linguistics tries to discover general principles. General principles. We also try to discover general principle governing human society. Trubetz Coy, founder of structural linguistics, four features. What is that? Conscious phenomena has no meaning. Enter into the unconscious infrastructure of the phenomena to understand the meaning. A. B. Do not take term as independent entities. Rather, make a coherence to understand the meaning. C. System. Four. General principles. All right? Levi-Strauss has taken another principle of linguistics, that is binary opposition. You understand binary opposition? What is binary opposition? In order to understand some phenomena, one has to understand its binary opposite first. What is good will be better understood if you know what is its exact opposite. What is positive will be better known if you know its exact opposite, that is negative. That is also found in the relationships. Okay. So this is over now. Structural linguistics. Four parts. Structure is a model. Model has four characteristics. Four types of model. Structural linguistics. Four features. Binary opposition. Now, structural analysis of kinship and myth, which we will do. What is structural analysis of kinship? In a society, Levi-Strauss, in a society where kinship is important, there four relationships are very important. F, C, A, S. We are talking about kinship. So obviously we are talking about simple societies, primitive societies, because Levi-Strauss analyzed them. Maybe that will be the criticism, because he has not analyzed much about complex societies in this structural anthropology volume. All right. F, C, A, S. F, filial. Filial. father-son relationships. C, conjugal, husband-wife relationship. A, avuncula, mother's brother and sister's son, MBZS relationship. Mother's brother and sister's son, sister is ZS relationship, short form. S, sibling, brother-sister relationship. FCAS. He has analyzed, for example, among Trobriand Islanders. Trobriand, you remember? Malinowski studied. Okay, off New Guinea. Where is New Guinea? Near New Zealand. All right, that side. Islands. He studied 1914 to 1918. Great. Produced a book in 1922. All right. So, among the matrilineal Trobrianders, mother's brother and sister's son relationship is very important. Mother's brother's property is inherited by sister's son. So it involves property and authority. Mother's brother and sister's son involves property and authority. What is that? A, avuncula. It is marked with hostility and antagonism. Why? Because it involves property and authority. There is a likelihood of argument. Wherever property and authority is involved, there is a likelihood of argument. There is a likelihood of violence. Maybe verbal or physical also sometimes. So it is a negative relationship. Bracket, in the bracket, minus. It is a negative relationship. It is all abstraction. Don't judge what you think negative and positive. Think about all these abstraction implementing methods and techniques Lévi-Strauss has analyzed. All right? You cannot understand in a simple mind. You can understand only in a sociological, anthropological mind. And sociology is not common sense. Mind it. All right. So, it is a negative relationship marked with hostility and antagonism. Whereas, among Trobriand, the father and son relationship is marked with free and familiarity. There is no stake. There is no stake of the son with the father. Free and familiarity. You understand? Yes, yes, I know him. Sort of. So, what is that? It's a positive relationship. In the bracket plus. Among the patrilineal Cherkess, the opposite is found. What is that? Patrilineal Cherkess tribe. Cherkess. The relationship between father and son is negative, marked with hostility, marked with antagonism, because it involves property and authority. Cherkess. The relationship between mother's brother and sister's son is positive, plus. Why? Marked with free and familiarity. Mother's brother presents a horse to the sister's son during his marriage. Interesting. So he gave a diagram. It's like this. It's like this. FCAS, arrow mark, plus, plus, minus, minus, plus, plus. Trobriand, kinship relations, Cherkess. Cherkess, patrilineal Cherkess, matrilineal Trobriand. You got it? Just the same, whatever I said, graphic representation. This one, huh? All right. He studied six tribes. He analyzed six tribes and gave a model. Same plus minus, just see. He gave a model, just see. First three are matrilineal, second three are patrilineal. Trobriand, Siwi, Dobu, Kubutu, Cherkess, Tonga. Six tribes, FCAS, plus, minus, 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 plus, 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 minus, minus, and the opposite, alternate. F's alternate is A, C's alternate is S. So, first F is top and bottom plus, in between 4 minus. Second is top 4 plus, bottom 2 minus, and alternately opposite. You can remember like this. How he has done it? On his own? No, no, no. Not on his own. By seeing the reality, this is a construction, this is a model. He gave this equation. F is to C is equal to A is to S. F is to C is equal to A is to S. Remember. Alright. Now it has to be seen whether it is a model or not. How? Number one, it looks like a system. How? There are four interconnected, interdependent parts. What is that? FCAS, they're interconnected, interdependent. Change in one will lead to change in the other. Suppose F becomes minus, then A will become plus. Like this. Predictability. Whatever is F, the opposite will be A. Whatever will be C, the opposite will be S. Transformation, it can change. Intelligibility through the equation F is to C and A is to S, it is intelligible. It is clear. So it is a model. Could you follow? How many parts? A, structure is a model. B, four characteristics of a model. C, four types of model. D, features of structural linguistics. E, analysis of kinship. Five things. One more we'll analyze, that is structural analysis of myths.